Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. In today's video, we are going to do a review of the new released series of LLMs with name Kaggin 2 Visual Language Model from Alibaba Cloud AI team. They recently released this improvement of the previous series that was the Kaggin VL models, and well, we are going to describe today what we had new. As you probably know, Kaggin is a flagship of the models that the Alibaba Cloud team was released, and then on they make some different versions of the original series, and this is one of the new releases that with vision or kind of the multimodal model that they had been released recently. You can see here Kaggin is the organization that belongs to Alibaba Cloud or inside Alibaba Cloud. For those that they don't know what is Alibaba, it's a cloud provider similar to what probably in size, I don't know if in terms of business, the size of the AWS, very no well known in China and in Asia continent, but here in Europe or America, probably it's not that known. But these guys are doing also very good stuff in terms of creating these different LLMs with different purposes. So as I said, the standard or the flagship was the model Kaggin. This had different releases already, different families. As you can see, the newest one is the Kaggin 2.5, but they also had released recently the Kaggin 2 visual language model, which is my opinion is a multimodal model, but well, they named that is a vision language model because it essentially had two main components: a vision transformer or a video vision transformer that they modified in combination with the model Kaggin 2 version 2. So as you can see on the architecture of the model, essentially we had a vision encoder, the conventional VIT, but with some improvements. They had transformed the model a little bit to allow with some of the newest techniques that had been researched and implemented. And after the image is passing through the vision encoder, is later on being used these tokens as input to the Kaggin LLM decoder in for language generation. So they, as I said, these people have produced, let me show you, three different versions of the model. You can see we are going to test today the smaller one, the 2 billions, a very small model. You will see that they had very good performance, very good quality on the output, and as I said, it's a combination of a vision encoder with an LLM. So three versions, three sizes, 2 billion, 7 billion, 72 billions. This is open source. The 2 billions and 7 billions are open source, and the other one is under license, Kaggin license. I'm not really sure what means, but well, you have here as well. I will patch you all this link as well with the notebook, as usual. I will later on upload the video. Sorry, the video and the notebook together to the notebook to the repository, and then on I will make a link to the in the description of the video to later on you'll be able to find it and use it or replicate what you are going to see on the video in your local environment. So they have implemented two new techniques. One is the naive dynamic resolution, which allows the model to not depend on the static or size or the your ability to resize the images to the fixed input that for that the vision the VIT the vision Transformers has, that you probably remember, is three channels by 224 by 224. Here, with implementing this new technique, night dynamic resolution, they allow us to don't care in terms of what is the resolution of the image or the video that we are using as input. This is well. Again, there is in this new technique with the name night dynamic resolution, which essentially is using another technique described from the paper with this two-dimensional road, which allow us to capture the relations at two dimensions rather than the one dimension that is used in the conventional BIT model. Additionally, they use another technique, multimodal rotary position embedding, which allows to capture relationships, three different relationships from the. This is more applying to videos rather than to images, and allow us to capture the relationship in three different aspects or perspective: temporal, height, and width. No, it's, rather than the ones that we do or use in the vision. In the Vivid Video Vision Transformer, where we just have two different, the tabular embedding or the linear embedding, which is essentially the two replicate the conventional encoding used in the Vision Transformer to multiple images. But here they apply new techniques, as I mentioned in many of the previous videos. This is evolving very, very fast. There is new techniques discovered every day, probably, and then they are implemented. People is trying different things, and every time, every day, new models, smaller, more powerful, and that have been implemented. We have changes either in hardware, techniques, and how to build the transformers, also software, new libraries which allow us to implement or to use this new hardware acceleration or different kinds of the runtimes, like we saw in the channel as well, to be more performance in GPUs, CPUs, or whatever. So there is people working in different directions, but everything converging into creating more and more powerful models, which smaller models at the same time, which are competing at the same level that bigger models, as you can see here on the performance. So they claim to be practically the 72 billion model at the same level that GPT-4o or Claude 3.5 Sonnet. You can see the numbers, compare the number of the different benchmarks, and it's really impressive. This model is probably 20 times or even less or even more times smaller than GPT-4o. It's really a small model. But as you can see, combining different new techniques, what you have today is probably in 6 months is even, it doesn't matter how much money you spend. It's gonna be all. And some of them are even higher. And look at the performance of the Queen 2, 2 billions. It's also impressive for a model of 2 billions of parameters. So imagine, if we compare the amount of money that probably OpenAI or Anthropic have to spend in training their models, and the infrastructure they need to run inference for these monsters, in comparison for the one that you need to run this small model, which is nothing. And they have a performance. Look at this number here with Claude 3.5. This is a state of the art. So this is the baseline, and some of them are really close for a really, this is a nano model, this is very, very small. Okay, so in the VL model, we have also option to get, we have already quantized models, so another exercise probably will be to to use a one of these quantized model in a CPU and test performance in terms of quality and also in terms of speed in a CPU, because well, it's not bad. What more? Okay, let's move to the code, because sometimes it's better to see this working rather than to me explaining the how wonderful is the model, because I already tested, I know what it's capable of. Also, let me show you something. According to the documentation, you can check here, come on. Is the model is for a multiple tags. You can do general chart, video understanding, OCR, multilingual, formula recognition, math coding. That is quite impressive. You probably saw in the video, you are a subscriber, you are following me on YouTube, probably you will see, you saw some of the videos we did about Florence or V3 Vision is really good model, but this two times this model that you are gonna see today, and we make the video of V3 Vision probably 3 months ago, and then on V3 from Microsoft is 4.2 billion. Let's check, because sometimes I forgot. Microsoft V3 Vision. So the model is where is the strat? One second, let me find the information. Cookbook, it's not grown, is this exactly V3. Now we had the 3.5. The original one is 4.2 billion. The new V3.5 Vision is 4.2 as well. So it's the new release. I will make a test soon. And we had this one as well. The MOE, but again, is the video that we're gonna test today is half of this. No, this model behaves very, very good as well. I was really impressed with both with the text version and the multimodal version. And you will see today that this model is also really, really impressive. Okay. Let's I get you here some of the links that you will need later to here on the documentation. You had links as well to the paper that described the night dynamic resolution and multimodal rotary position embeddings and rope, if you are interested in the details of these new techniques implemented on this model. Here I patch you what you need to install. As you can see, I'm using a Colab Pro. Here you have the descriptions of the models 3. We are going to use the VL2B, 675 million parameters on the vision encoder, and the Kawin 2, 1.5 billion. So it's a nano model, a nano LLM. We use FFmpeg. To extract frames from video, and head down is just to download one of the videos. This is just an example. We download the video here to local. It's a video of a lady doing some gymnastics. 10 seconds. Okay. Now with FFmpeg, we extract the samples and we put it in this frame. I will explain you later on down why. And here we are gonna use, we're gonna take or we're gonna review some of the use cases. First of all, describe an image. Let's import it again. We download the image. It's a little bit bigger, but I just resize it to not occupy too much. And here we just there is two options to run the inference, to run the generation. With the Kawin, provide some utils to work with the model. It's essentially prepare template message and pass the content. The content can be image or can be video. If you pass the content, the image can be a URL, it can be a URI to the, it can be also bytes, so you can pass whatever you want. If you pass a URL, the model, the utils in this case will download the image and pass the device to the model. Here we just apply the template and you process with process vision info. Here we have the video, we got two output, video input and image inputs, we pass to the processor. And after the processor, we move to the GPU and generate. As you can see here, it's describing, and I don't know if you see, but it's the image, the pitch. So the description is quite descriptive, very well done. And here you have the same, but produce it with a. The conventional transformers pipeline. That is with the processor and with model generator. Here we are not using, we are just using the template and that's it. We can do the same, we should obtain the same, but we obtain the same output in any case. We can compare, it's exactly the same. We are just limiting here to 128 new tokens, and you can see that is exactly the same description. But again, more practical probably to use the tools that Kawin provide or Alibaba provide. Here we are going to do OCR, this small image with an OCR of the Excel table, Excel sheet. I asked to extract everything and format it into a table. I will see that now it's just extracting. And doing really very good quality. Oops. Probably I didn't pass this correctly. No worries. You have it here. Okay. So OCR as well. Now I pass the animes with the evolution of the cross margin of the Tesla stop. I just pass it here and I pass as well, you can see here context, I just pass the image and I'm using here the image. We are using simply the directly transformers, transformer processor and the model loaded with the with the tools of Hugging Face or transformers, and here you can see compare the gross profit margin of Tesla from Q1 to Q2, the excess represent quarters, blah blah blah. Here, this I'm not 100% agree because this is probably below 15, but in any case, it's doing very good job. Again, this is consider that it's a model of 2 billion parameters. We can do a comparison with Claude Sonnet, and you will see that this is not, or with GPT-4o, it will not be much better than this. Describe video. So here we have two options. Either we pass a list of frames, as you probably know, the video is just a sequence of frames, and then here we can do some approach similar to what we do in video classification. Just choose randomly a section of the video and create a sequence of frames. We have to respect the order. In any case, as we did on the sequence, you can just specify randomly the end, calculate the start, and we can decide to create a list of frames from beginning to end with some gaps in between, and this is the representation of this video. This is the approach that we use when we do the video classifier in the channel some weeks ago, and then this is similar. You can either decide to do it randomly, but the only thing that you need to respect is the files, the frames have to be in order. You can do it like this, or you can just simply pass the link to the video, like in this here, the file, and then use the utils that Kawin provide. You can use it directly like this, no? You choose it here, you have the content, video type video, if you use image, type image. But the format is exactly the same. We are conversating with the model. We are passing here a model, which is essentially one I use in the video classification model, this one. So the video shows a person standing at a yard, holding a bow and arrow. They are adjusting the ball. But you can take a look, it's this video. Okay, so it's a video with how many seconds? 10 seconds as well. And you see the. Oops. Yeah. A trampoline and some trees suggesting about. I didn't see this. Let me once. Ah, yeah, exactly. This is a trampoline with some trees suggesting a backyard setting. Okay, and now we are going to see what we get from the video that we download with the lady who is doing some gymnastics. And again, it's really impressive, in my opinion, the speed of the video generation. It's really fast in comparison with some of the images. And that's pretty much all. I didn't test all the use cases, but you can see that it's pretty simple. You just point to the image or the video, and you ask in a conversation to the model. Okay, that's all. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for watching the video up to this point. I hope that you find this interesting and useful for your job, for your training, for whatever reason that you're watching this video. And if so, just give me a like, subscribe to the channel if you didn't do it before, share with your friends, etc., etc. And that's all. Thank you very much, and see you soon.